The Edge is quite simply a new approach to running what is traditionally known as the cloud in nearby data centers much closer to the end user. Think of it as a new hierarchy of data centers that come in big, medium, and small sizes. There's many, many use cases driving edge computing. As I like to think of it, they come in roughly two areas. The first area is the traditional IoT use cases. Things like supporting very large amounts of data and doing some pre-processing in the edge before distributing the output of this pre-processing up into the cloud, and that would apply in applications like telemetry and industrial IoT. There's the flip side of this as well, where you need to distribute very large amounts of information to a local geography, and this would apply in things like autonomous cars that require an enormous amount of information to drive their operation. That would be a second category of IoT use cases, if you like. The second category, in my mind, that is more exciting is the category of a function virtualization in the edge. And I think that is often people ask, is that the same thing as doing CDNs? And the truth of that is it's not. It's a common misconception. It's not doing CDNs. CDNs is basically just caching. When we talk about doing network function virtualization in the edge, we're talking about bringing up whole new server functionalities. Think HBO, think Amazon, think Netflix. Being able to spin them up on the fly at the edge. What does this mean? The profound impact over time as the edge fully rolls out, what we'll see is a profound improvement in user experience. We may see the end of the donut of death experience that we're so familiar with. I think the edge computing in the future could have potentially profound impacts even down at the device level. There are a number of dependencies here. The big one, I believe, is obviously the scaling out of 5G capabilities, in particular the ultra-reliable, low-latency capability. With that in a somewhat prolific place, it's quite conceivable that we could see a reimagination of device technologies moving to much lighter form factors, and possibly even enabling a future where basically any screen can become your screen by simply looking at it.